What's up, everyone? Welcome back for the next race. All right, so this is going to be actually a pretty exciting race. So going to be trying out the Ford F-150 SVT Raptor for the first time in this game. Obviously, again, I, you know, race this car in GT Sport, but this is my first time doing it in this game. This is also my very first ever dirt race in Gran Turismo 7. So, yeah, I'm excited for that. And also, apparently now in this game, you can actually race more than two cars on a dirt track, which is fucking awesome. Because, like, in the past GT games, it's always been just two cars, at least to the best of my knowledge. It's always been two cars. At least I know in GT 3 and GT Sport, I know for a fact that it was two cars. So being able to race more than two cars on a dirt track is fucking cool. So, yeah, definitely looking forward to this. Looking forward to seeing what this track looks like in GT 7. And, yeah, we're going to have ourselves some fucking fun here, so get this fucking show on the road. Yeah, let's see what this motherfucker can do. Yeah, actually, the vehicle that I learned how to drive with was a 2008 Ford F-150. That was the car that, or truck, I should say, that I learned how to drive with, like when I was getting the hours, you know, for when I had my driving permit. You know, before I got my driver's license and shit. So, yeah. I was also kind of pissed, though, because, like, earlier later in the week last week, I actually could have gotten more Gran Turismo 7 shit done for you guys, but the server was down, and so I couldn't access, like, anything. Which, again, is the one, like, complaint I have about this game. Like, everything about this game is fantastic. Like, the graphics, the actual gameplay is spectacular. But the always needing to be connected to the server in order to do, like, anything in this game is kind of bullshit. Like, especially for a game that has a lot of, like, single-player content. Like, I understand, you know, being, you know, having to be connected to the server in order to play online and shit like that. Like, that I totally understand. You know, that's reasonable. But, you know, having to have, like, a constant connection to the server in order to do, like, even just single-player content, like, just missions for the GT Cafe and shit like that. Like, that's kind of dumb, honestly. Like, and I get it, they're trying to prevent people from cheating, but there's better ways to do it than that. Also, if people are, you know, if people want to cheat, they're going to find ways to cheat. It's unavoidable, you know, so. I just feel like that's the one drawback to this game, is that you always have to be online, which is kind of dumb. But, yeah, that's just my humble opinion. So, I could have gotten more shit done last week, but I wasn't able to because of that. The game was down for like a whole two fucking days, and it was really aggravating. Though I did get some other shit done, so it wasn't a complete waste. But yeah, I love the graphical improvements they made to this track. It looks really fucking good. I mean, again, that's no surprise. I mean, I haven't run into a track in this game that I thought didn't look good. I mean, if nothing else, at least the, you know, graphics in this game are fucking spectacular. And the gameplay itself is really good, too. So, again, at least this game's got that going for it. Beyond a doubt. Again, dirt racing is not my specialty, but I feel like I'm doing okay so far. I say as I almost spin out there. The only thing that's kind of annoying about dirt versus asphalt is that, like, you have to switch the tires every time. So if you go from dirt to asphalt, you know, you have to go into the GT Tune shop and switch your tires. And whereas in GT Sport, it was just kind of like an automatic thing. Like, you automatically have dirt tires if you're racing on dirt. And you automatically have, you know, asphalt tires if you're racing on asphalt. So that's kind of annoying, but, you know, is what it is. I mean, I understand having to, you know, unlock the dirt tires. You know, that was a thing in, you know, GT3 even. But even in GT3, they would still let you race on the asphalt tracks even if you had dirt tires. So I think it's kind of dumb, you know, to not let you race on asphalt when you're racing with dirt tires. Even in GT3, they didn't have that issue. But, yeah, whatever. But yeah, not bad for my first dirt race. Feel like that truck handled well. We're going to be seeing a little bit more of that truck coming up, too. So, hope you all are ready for that. Because I got some more missions to complete for the GT Cafe, which is why I went out and bought this particular vehicle. Yeah, it is one thing I wish they would add more of is, like, a couple more pickup trucks. You know, again, like a, maybe like a Chevy Silverado or a, you know, Dodge Ram or some shit like that. I think that'd be cool. I mean, I'm happy that there are at least, you know, two, you know, different pickup trucks in this game, but that's still something I wish they'd add more of, is pickup trucks. But again, at least they still added a couple. It's at least something. But yeah, typically speaking, like, full-size pickup trucks and shit are not the best racing vehicles. Typically not as fast, you know, as far as speed is concerned. I mean, they have a lot of power, but they're not as fast as far as speed is concerned, typically. I mean, they have a fair amount of speed. They're definitely not, you know, it's not going to be as slow as, like, a Fiat 500, you know. But they're not, you know, supercars in the sense that they have a lot of speed. It's because they're bigger, bulkier, so they don't have the same, like, level of aerodynamicy as other vehicles. But they have a lot of raw power. Yeah, I love the graphical improvements that they made to this track. Looks absolutely incredible. Yeah, definitely some cool shit. Alright, well guys, that'll do for that one. Peace out.